want to be on YouTube, but coming to you live at the time of filming here, I'm at the New Egypt Flea Market in New Jersey. Let's go and see what kind of things they have here for sale. Right here.
It's a Ford trademark, made in Japan Ford. Some nice old antique metal, probably 70s. This is metal too. Cool. Get the back in there. So how does it work?
Alright. Four buttons here. One goes, makes you go left and right.
Yeah.
These two, three, and four make you go up and down. Little chute opens up.
Is that an antique though?
This is the 50s. Now the little transmission back here. You flick it up. I'm trying to work on a track now. I got a broken track on it, but.
Oh yeah.
That makes it go forward or reverse.
So if you were that guy that was like, he stole the tank in California, he got caught in the basement, and I think a track came off, and he ended up killing himself. But he had it all covered. It was a tanker. It was something. No, it was something like this.
Okay.
And he had it all like armored.
Oh yeah.
And he lasted a long time until one of the tracks came off.
You're talking about when he went nuts and wrecked that whole town.
Oh yeah.
We called him Killdozer.
Oh, Killdozer. Yeah.
He was Killdozer.
Crazy. That's cool, dude.
He built that to the shore of town.
Well, thanks for showing it. The K25.
Made in the 50s.
That's some beautiful shape.
The operator actually works.
So this is from the 50s. Looks like brand new.
Yeah. So it's mechanical. And the operator actually works it when it turns left or right. The only problem issue with this, it does run. Let's see what happens. Tracks they get bored. The hardest things about this stuff is the tracks. The tracks are rubber. They wear out. They wear out, and then.
Well, I mean, this is 60 years old.
Yeah.
It's amazing. I'd want.
And I got the box for it. So.
If I had a collection, I'd want this in my collection. Yeah. It looks like brand new. Well, it's been in the box.
Yeah, it's got a pretty unique remote. You know what I mean?
It runs
like
on
little,
D's.
Like a little bulldozer.
Yeah, it runs on D's. That's really cool. Well, it's neat that you have that. You don't see that every day. Thanks.
Yeah.
Beautiful. All kinds of things for sale here. There's a ton of different vendors selling everything. Over here, I don't know what those are. Toys. A lot of toys for the kids. And then collectibles. And these cool old buildings. Kind of neat. It's like some Amish things. Guys, carving a bear. some really nice things here. Soapbox derby wheels. That's really cool for a unique project. You don't see those. I've never seen those before. And I guess this is, this is from Philadelphia. I think it's a milk jug or something. Holds 6 gallons. And then they have a lot of nice early wear here. And this is free. Like, you put some, can you imagine some cranberries or strawberries in that? And the price isn't so bad. Yeah, well done. Nice, it's bright. So I got a earful earlier. Some African things. This whole place is owned by a guy who just recently passed, and his wife's running it. He might sell it, and I told him everybody should come together here and come up with money and form a co-op so they could always have it and run it their own way. Otherwise, it'll probably go to a developer and turn it to condos or something boring. Probably condos or industrial space. Just a thought.